I should know more Japanese. 14 years mm-hmm. coming back and forth from Japan. Mm-hmm. I feel ashamed that I don't know more, you know?
Me too. Who's your best Japanese teacher for you?
Probably Shinsuke when he was here. Whoa. Shinsuke taught me a lot of Japanese and like kind of like rare words. He helped. He told me about Nakasuzo Konoyaro. He taught me that. Yeah. And Shibakuzo and everything. So, he was a big influence teaching me Japanese, and then I would help him with English. So that's kind of always been our thing.
It's always weird to work. Your main source of income is from working in another country.
Yes.
Especially like Japan and the States are so different. Yeah.
When I tell people, if they ask me like, oh, what's your job? And I say, you know, I'm like, oh, pro wrestler. And they're like, oh, where? And I'm like, Japan. And they're like, what?
Yeah.
What? And then they're like, how does that work? And I'm like, I go to Japan like 2 or 3 weeks. Like I'm home like 2 weeks. And then I go back and forth all year long. And they're just like, what?
Yeah.
It's always the thing. What?
Yeah, that's.
It's wild. It's wild.
Yeah.
And then how long have you been doing that? Oh, 14 years. What?
Big somebody.
Oh, thank you. I couldn't imagine doing anything else.
Mm-hmm, like me too.
Yeah, I've never really had another job. This has always been my job because I started so young. And, I couldn't imagine, you know, working anywhere else or doing like a desk job or like even like I just couldn't imagine I couldn't understand it, you know?
Yeah.
There's a weird thing that I've talked to a lot of wrestlers about this and I ask them like when you were a kid and you started pursuing being a wrestler, or even before you started pursuing it, did you ever picture it not working out? And everyone pictured it working out, and there's something about the guys who knew they were gonna do it are the guys who did it and made it their job.
Right.
And me and Rocky, since I was 9 years old, I was telling my mom I'm gonna be a wrestler. I was telling her it was easy, and we only had to work one day a week, because Monday Night Raw was only on once a week, so That's what I thought the work schedule was. I was wrong, but I still knew I was going to do it. How old were you when you knew?
I think I was like, I was in middle school. I want to say like maybe 14 or so, 13 or 14.
Like, I'm going to do that.
Yeah, and I was like,
there's no question, there's no doubt.
Yeah, I was like, I'm going to do this job. No matter what, I'm going to do this job. And I already had a plan. Mm-hmm. You know,
yeah.
It's like, I'm not going to go to university.
Me too.
I'm going to go straight to learning wrestling, and I'm going to, you know, my whole goal was to go to Japan already, you know.
This is a lesson. Don't doubt yourself.
Yeah.
With whatever your dream is, just go do it.
Just do it.
We're getting
believe
all
in yourself.
And lame, but it's real.
Yeah, it's true. Because like he said, is like our friends who have been successful in professional wrestling, they always knew that they were going to be wrestlers. And if you have some doubt, and it probably won't happen, you know? You have to, like, just go.
Mm-hmm.
Just do it.
So. Chaos guys, like, I don't know if it's because I can't speak the language, but I don't think it is, but I feel like all the guys are just nice and everyone wants to help each other out.
Right.
And nobody's trying to backstab each other. Like, some things in the States were, you just get a weird feeling about people trying to hold people down and things like that. And then, like, I mean, it's obvious that in-ring New Japan is the best wrestling in the world. Keep going. It's so hot. Oh, sorry, I don't know what that means.
Okay, this.
Oh shit!
Hey!
Okay.
Okay.
Alright.
You want some, you want some of this good green stuff?
No.
You want some green stuff?
Oh, no, it's going to be on there.
No?
Let's go. You ready?
No, I'm ready. Any little green stuff? Wasabi. You gotta have wasabi.
You like wasabi?
I love wasabi. Some of the best shisu I ever had in my life.
Mmm.
Shisu and gyeopong. Mm.
It's really good.
What a lucky life.
I'm gonna go pee, Rocky, okay?
Okay, hey, thank you.
Thanks.
Beretta, honestly, I've had a lot of partners in my wrestling career. Before it was Ricky Reyes, then Davey Richards, Alex Kozlov, Forever Hooligans, and then now Beretta. But he's my favorite partner, my best partner. His wrestling technique is amazing, but even more personality is great. Like, he's just a good person. My other partners are good people, but like, he's really like good person. Easy to work with for me, you know? Because that's important. You hear sometimes like tag teams, it's the worst if like they don't get along with each other, you know? That's why like Young Bucks are so special, because they're brothers, you know? They really get along great. That's important. So like, when he came to New Japan, we like gelled easily, quickly. And I think that that's what makes our team like, instantly we were like successful, you know? And I love that guy. He's like my little brother in a way, you know? Like, it really feels like though. He's a good dude. So then Beretta, I was like, step.
What? What? You're stabbing me? That's planned? What?
No, nothing, man. Nothing, man.
Do it right. So what are you saying about stabbing me?
Nothing, man. Nothing, man. I was just saying I would never stab you in the back, man.
No, this isn't Japanese style.
Should we get another one? Should we ping pong?
We're just tequila it.
Ping pong!
I just asked about your impression to Rocky. So, how would you describe him?
Should I leave the room? I'll leave the room.
So you can say.
No. I think it's better, you know?
No, I want you to say.
If there's something that you want to say, you can get off your chest.
You have to pee?
Yeah.
Okay, now that he's gone. Stand the guy. He's so loud. He's always saying his catchphrases. I'm sick of him. To be honest, one day in the ring when he turns his back, you know, I just gotta do what's best for me. That's it. But no.
That's it.
No.
Are you sure?
He's one of the nicest humans in the world. He's the best dude, like, not even counting him in the ring, which is always great. He's like this little crazy wild man in the ring who beats people up more than I do, which I think is hilarious because I'm this tall and Rocky's. But no, he's just like the friendliest dude. It's such an easy team. Like we've seen each other so much within the past year, and we've never been in an argument. We've had little disagreements, but not even, like, pretty much non-existent disagreements about little things that we're trying to do in matches. But for the most part, no, we don't fight. He's the nicest guy ever. He's the best. I have nothing bad to say about him. What a good partner to have. That's it. But don't tell him I said any of that. And like, just waste time, because it's just as
long. What the fuck? Oh. Oh. Maybe gang. Some gang or something. Oh. I go toilet, then Somebody, oh, attack me. Oh, itai.
You're drunk as shit. So,
see what's that? See what's that?
Hold your thing. Hold it.
Yep, okay.
Why'd you do that?
Sorry.
Hey, why'd you do that, man?
Japanese party joke.
Is that
Japanese party joke?
Is that a Japanese party
that
joke?
That is a Japanese party joke.
For real?
That's a. I got it from Yano Toru. No. Oh, same as that.
Really?
Japanese party joke, man.
Is that a classic joke?
It's a.
You've seen it before?
No.
First time. No.
Oh, that's good.
A little hotter than I expected.
Yeah, I like it. I like it. I'm hoping so, like, this is my, I have a future plan for Rapunzel.
I'll just
guys.
Do me.
I'm gonna say, I'm gonna let everybody know. The future plan is more times IWGP Junior Tag Team title, right? But then Beretta wins Best of Super Junior, okay? Then he wins IWGP Junior Single Belt, right? Right? Then he wins the championship, throws it down, and says, I'm gonna be heavyweight. Wow. And Rocky is gonna be my manager. Same thing like Rainmaker and Gato, Beretta and Romero. But I'm the Rain Taker, I'm the manager. And he moves to heavyweight, next IWGP champion. And I'm the manager. That's my dream, my
this
goal.
This is just, so basically you want-
5 year plan.
Basically, you want me to do all the work
yes.
while you just do this.
Basically, I want him to do all the work, and I just go like this, and I take 10%. That's it.
Well, here's the that. Nope, lock it in with
oh,
me.
Oh, lock it in.
Five-year plan?
Five-year plan.
Let's lock in
starts,
the plan.
Starts today.
Lock the plan in.
Lock it in. Five-year plan starts today. I think we both spilled.
Nope, just me.
That's good. No, me too. And that is the 5 year plan of Roppongi Vice.
But at that point, it's pretty much just the plan of me, like, and you're the little side thing.
That is the 5 year plan
of me
of
featuring Rocky.
Beretta's career featuring Rocky Romero.
So that's not even enough? I mean, okay.
Yeah.
No, it sounds cool.
Okay. You're in?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
cool.
Let's do it.
Cool.
But should we say?
Bye, everyone. Thanks for watching our interview on New Japan World on the road.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think you're going to finish watching this and feel like you accomplished anything. But
if you do.
But thanks for doing it.
Right.
And in the end, I'm sorry. I'm sorry you finished it, to be honest. Are you too?
That's depressing, man. Roppongi. Roppongi. Roppongi Lights, Roppongi Vice. Beretta, where you going, man? What? You're just gonna stand outside and just...